Hey, you doing here? Okay, so here's my side splash that I finished with Seahawk gel coat, and been here 4 days, 5 days or something drying, and got my second camera going here. Still, so that if this one wasn't very good picture, the other one might see a little bit. But I'm ready to take the masking tape off, see what it looks like. I'm missing the whole thing. Where is it? There it is. Okay. That's the backside, and you know, it's, well, it's a real thin coat, so that's why you can see the streaks in there. It doesn't matter because it's the backside. But I'm just gotta join the. Probably don't have that in the frame of the other camera, but this is, makes it harder trying to do two at once, isn't it? Two cameras. So. It's really nice and smooth on that end, and that's what I was wanting, because the original finish is very smooth, because they do it in a mold. They spray it in a mold and then pour the cultured marble in on it. So I'm going to peel this. That's why I set the other camera up. I'm going to peel this off. Let me see if I'm in the shot here. Yeah, as long as I stay close. Not. Yeah, by that hole in the stuff or a little further, then I'll be all right. Yeah. Okay, that's a good mark. You need something on your table to tell you where to be. I just realized this camera's not even recording. I don't know what happened with it. Ah, quit working. So that faint voice in the camera there will be all I got. These cameras, this app, I like it, but it's, I just want, let's see. Let's go ahead and go on with what I'm doing. And I'll make that close-up video. This one wasn't going to be any good anyway. I'll make that close-up video after I get the stuff peeled off. I guess it's a good thing I did that. I didn't realize that. What happens is you'll hit video and it'll look like it's on, and then it'll go right back off within 5-10 seconds. And if you don't realize it, then you're in trouble. You're not making a video, you're talking to yourself. So, I may need a knife or something. I think I'll go get my utility knife. Okay, got that. Now, make sure I'm still recording, yeah. Red light's still on. Okay, yeah, this, one thing you really, the longer you leave, don't want to mess up the finish. The longer you leave masking tape, the more it wants to stick to what you got it on. Actually, it seems like I'm able to just get it like that better. I don't want to scratch on it. I wrapped it all the way around all edges because they were finished. All the edges that were finished, I should say. I'm trying to be careful not to scratch up my pre-finished edge. think the finish, the new finish I sprayed on there, kind of wanted to seal it, adhere it to the thing even more there on the edges. To my toolbox, I had it propped up. Once I get the end is all taped up too, I'm starting to. I wanted to start at the end, but it seemed hard to get off, so I just started at the first place that would come loose. If I hang it off the edge, I'll end up dropping it. That would be a disaster because this stuff is brittle and it would break. This is the finished edge, but this rounded edge is gonna be down. It's not gonna be seen. So actually, I guess I picked the right one. I'm feeling mosquito chewing on my arm. I picked the right one to start with, I think. Peeling. The one that's gonna show is the one you want to, especially not chip or anything. Of course, you don't do it. You know, it's gonna be caulking on all the edges. And everything. That'll work. I had you loose. It's doing pretty good though. I was afraid that it's been on here 4 or 5 days. I was afraid it wasn't going to come off. Sometimes masking tape will stick real bad, especially when it's hot weather. This hasn't been hot weather. It's been cool. Anywhere from 38 to 35, say, to 70. Anyway, 30s at night. Mostly it's been like 45, 49 at night, I think. Now, here's the thing. There's my point where the old and new finish can go together. I don't believe I'll need that anymore, but I'll put it up there. Okay, there it is. There's a little bit of that problem I was worried about having the masking tape, you know, splitting off and making little strips that didn't want to come off, but it's okay. Already got the biggest part of it off. I can smell my stuff now. I don't know, maybe after I peeled that off there was one or two little wet spots. That's one thing I kind of got to thinking that might. I just wanted to get it off here before it adhered. To the point that I couldn't hardly get it on. It can really be a pain to get off. I usually kind of the rule I've always been told, there's one of those mosquitoes, is like 2 days really. But it does have a lot to do. Having problems with it coming off does have everything to do with the temperature. Yeah. I hear birds. I think we got a flock of birds. Is this the plant? Okay, I still have some. There they go, all the birds. what kind they are, but there's a bunch of them flying over them. They're not ducks. Not very big. Okay, so don't want to use the knife in there. I don't have to. Can't tell if what I'm. Let's see. That right there. It should have been a straighter edge than that, so I think that that's just masking tape. But that's where I'm going to have to try to sand it, smooth it in, blend them in together. But I think it's going to have to dry longer. It doesn't feel very, it doesn't feel hard at all. And if you sand on this stuff when it's not dry, it will make the most horrible black that you can't get off of it. It has a good feel to it. I mean, it's not at all tacky, but I think I'm kind of thinking that it got up under my. I'm gonna get my magnifying glass. Yeah, okay. So that is tape. That's tape there. I don't think that would work, would it? Not really. But that's tape. You can see it better when I held it up. That's tape down there. I just don't want to mess up my edge of my finish. Okay, there. Now, see, I can actually, it actually helps me to put it in front of the camera. I can, it makes it a little bigger to me. I can get it in the right light. Dang mosquitoes. I knew this would be a bad time. It's about 4:30, maybe getting close to 5. But, in the evening, not in the morning. So that's when mosquitoes come out. And almost the end of November and we got mosquitoes just like it was spring or summer. That's Texas now. That's what Texas weather's like now. North Texas anyway. Down Fort Worth, Dallas. Okay, so that is not hard enough for me to sand it. I can tell that. So I'm just going to let it sit and dry some more. It's too late for me to really do this, I think, anyway. It'll take me, I'd be lucky if I got it sanded in 30 minutes or so, and then I have to go put it in. That'd take an hour, probably. But, the backside is, you can kind of see a little graininess to it, but it's a real thin coat, and I just wanted to, since I was already spraying, I just wanted to coat it. All I really needed to coat was that end, where I cut it and rounded it off. But you can kind of see that line, I think, in the camera. Hopefully it comes in out better. So a lot of times it doesn't look too great in the viewfinder there, and then it comes out better in the actual video. But that line is got to be blended in as best as possible, but without scratching, especially the original finish, you know. So what I think I may do, I was thinking I'll put another piece of tape across there, but leave just a hair of space. Oops, just like a 1/16 of an inch. And then I was thinking I'd try to do it on both sides, but there's not enough room down here on that radius. So I will put masking tape on there. Once it's good and dry, and then I'll sand. I'll use that tape to keep me from scratching my original finish. I'm gonna use 400 or 500, whatever it is I got. It's that black wet sanding paper, and that might be one reason why. Of course, most all that paper's black, but why it makes black on there when you try to sand with it. Now I wasn't trying to sand with anything heavier than that. I didn't want to have to try to get the scratches out. And that was actually on this other piece. Let me put this, just put it over there on the box to sit there and be drying. My scrap piece from my big part, my big top, is still really, you can still see the brush strokes, and don't know how, yeah, you can kind of see them on the camera, can't you? But I've sprayed more coats on, every time I use it to kind of get my, see how my spray gun's doing and get it started. That was a bad run there, that my spray gun was dripping. But anyway, you can see the spray pattern on there. But I did sand it a little bit, and this one locked. I never dry, because I brushed it, and that did not work at all. And then I kept spraying it, and I really didn't get my mix completely right until this time. I think I'll lay it down this time. It's really tricky, you know. You got to go by the temperature, and you got to go by the. You got to get the right amount of hardening and everything. A little bit more tape there. But, I scratched it. No, it's just tape. I'm not going to keep fooling with it. Keep forgetting I'm getting out of the camera. But I didn't really think that just lightly touching it with that Exacto box cutter that it would really, you know, hurt it. But okay, I'll stop this video and see about, I'll do a little bit short one with my other phone with handheld. But there we go. But I'm gonna let it dry more before I touch it with sandpaper. Alright.